CIET-NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 6.
Hello children. Today we will be discussing chapter 2 whole numbers from your NCERT textbook, mathematics textbook. And before I begin, I hope you are doing great and are having a lovely time with your family members and friends. I know, you are not able to go out and play with your friends, but still, you are spending time with your family members. And you know, the chapter is whole numbers. And today, we will be talking about numbers. A special family of numbers called whole numbers. Okay, can anyone tell me how you started counting your numbers or learning numbers? Yes, we all started with number 1. This is how we teach small children in primary school, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. These are my counting numbers. And you know what happened yesterday? Yesterday, I met a small girl, Rita. You know, Rita likes laddus and her mother make very delicious laddus. And whenever her mother makes laddus, Rita used to feel, all these laddus only I should eat. Nobody else in the family should get the laddus. But this never happens, right? So Rita had to share laddus with the family members. This week also, Rita's mother made some laddus. And while she was making laddus, Rita started counting the laddus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And she said, just 8 laddus? Oh God, these laddus will not be enough for me. She wanted to eat all the 8 laddus herself. But her mother asked her, Rita, give one laddu each to all the members in the family. So Rita had to give her father one laddu. One laddu to her younger brother. One laddu she has to give to her mother. And one laddu to herself. So how many laddus she distributed? 4 laddus. So how many was remaining? She counted. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh no, only 4 laddus are left. Nothing can be done. She was greedy because her mother made delicious laddu. At dinner time, her mother again asked Rita to distribute the laddus among family members. And this time, you know how she did? She said, this is 4th laddu I'm giving to my father. This is 3rd laddu I'm giving to my brother. This is 2nd laddu I'm giving to my mother. And this remaining one, I am eating. And now, when her mother asked, Rita, how many laddus are left? She said, no laddus. Her brother, a little elder to her, said, tell me in numbers, how many laddus are left? She said, no laddu left. Her brother was a little irritated. Said, don't you know your numbers? Tell me in numbers how many laddus are left. Instead of English, tell me it in numbers, in mathematics. Again, Rita said, I told you na, no laddu left. And she left the room, went out of the home to enjoy her laddu. Can any of you help Rita in replying her brother how many laddus are left? When there is nothing left, you know, in mathematics, what we call it? In mathematics, we call it zero. Zero means nothing. Okay. And how do I write zero? Yes. I know you all are very smart. You know how to write zero. Just make a symbol like English letter O and you have your zero. Or you can write it like a very small circle. So, zero has a symbol of circle as you already know. So, when nothing is left, we call it is 0. So correct answer that Rita's brother was asking her was 0 laddu left. Okay. Now, so when you have no eraser, you can say I have 0 eraser. And when there are no toffees, you can say there is 0 toffee. So in mathematics, when we do not have anything left, we say it is 0. Oh, so now you see Rita's brother was little smarter than Rita. He was trying Rita to help identify number 0. Okay, now you know that we all started counting numbers from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we never start counting the numbers from 0. When you start counting from number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you keep on going on and on and on, thousands, 10,000s, 100,000s, more than that also, you keep on counting. Try this one day. Start counting from the morning breakfast and keep on continuing till your playtime, lunchtime, then evening tea time, then dinner time. And you know, you will find that you can go on and on and on. We don't have any number that we can say, yes, after this number, there is nothing left. No, that never happens. You can go on counting on and on and on. But when you are starting your counting with 1, you are counting the natural numbers. Okay. And when you add 0 to it, then this number family of natural number has a new number, new member, which is very small. And the smallest member of the family, when family which is 0, is added to the family of natural numbers, we get a new family of numbers which is known as whole numbers. So what are whole numbers? Whole numbers are nothing but 0 added to the natural numbers. And what are natural numbers? Natural numbers are my counting numbers. And how do I convert counting numbers into whole numbers? By adding 0 to the natural numbers. And why natural numbers become whole number by adding 0 to it? Because by adding 0 to the family of natural numbers, I have a mathematic symbol for nothing. Nothing in English. Okay. So, now you know the difference between the natural numbers and the whole numbers. And you know one more thing. Whole number also, when you start counting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and go on and on and on, you will again not be able to reach the biggest or the end of the numbers. Why? Because you have simply added 0 to the counting numbers and you have made this entire family whole numbers. Okay. And how do I represent this whole numbers? Recall the spelling of whole number, W-H-O-L-E. So I represent this family of whole numbers by the English capital letter W. And how do I represent the natural numbers? Natural number starts with N. So I represent natural number N with English capital letter N. So natural numbers are my simple counting numbers starting with 1 and whole numbers where I have a symbol 0 for counting nothing or telling someone that there is nothing left. Okay. Now, let us recall what is predecessor and what is successor. So, who can tell me the predecessors of 91? Don't raise your hand. I know you all are habitual of raising your hand. Just tell me what is the predecessor, or write in your notebook what is the predecessor of 91? Yes, it is 90. And how do I calculate the predecessor? To calculate the predecessor, I just have to subtract 1 from the given number. And when I subtract 1 from 91, I get 90, which is predecessor of 91. And suppose I need to find successor of 91, what it would be? Successor of 91 would be 92. And how do I come to 92? By adding number 1 to the given number 91. So 91 plus 1 is 92. So now you recall, predecessor can be found by subtracting number 1 and successor can be found by adding number 1. Okay. Can you tell me 91 is a natural number or whole number? Yes. So, if my counting numbers is starting with 0 and I'm reaching 91, then 91 is my whole number. And if my counting number is beginning from 1 and I'm reaching 91, then 91 will belong to the family of natural numbers. Yes. Okay. Tell me any natural number which has both successor and predecessor. Yes. You must be thinking, what stupid question this is. All natural numbers have successor and predecessors. Okay, fine, I accept. No, you're wrong here. There is one natural number who doesn't have a predecessor. Let's see who reaches that number. The natural number which doesn't have a predecessor is number 1. Why? Because if you'll subtract 1 from 1 to find its predecessor, you will reach a 0. And you're very smart. You know that 0 doesn't belong to a natural number. So the only natural number which doesn't have a predecessor is 1. Okay, yes, wasn't that fun? It is. You just make numbers your friend. Then you can have all of this kind of fun with the numbers. Okay, so a whole number is when we add 0 to natural numbers. I'll keep on reminding you this fact in this class today. Okay, let's find the predecessor and successor of few numbers. The first number is 19. How do I find the predecessor of 19? To find the predecessor of 19, I have to subtract 1 from 19. 19 minus 1 is 18. So 18 is predecessor of 19. How do I find successor of 19? 19 plus 1 is 20. So 20 is successor of 19. Now, few of you must be wondering, how do I remember for predecessor I need to subtract and for successor I need to add? So remember, success comes after hard work. Okay, and successor is related to success. And so successor we can find by adding. So it will come after the number. Okay. So let's try to find predecessor and successor of 1997. What would be its successor? Success comes after. So add one number to 1997 and you will reach 1998. So 1998 is successor of 1997. Now what would be its predecessor? For its predecessor, you can relate it to Hindi word pehle. Pehle starts with pa and predecessor also starts with p. So just subtract one number and you will reach 1997 minus 1, which is equal to 1996. So here 1996 is the predecessor. Okay, now let me give you a very easy number. 49. What is the predecessor of 49? Oho, your smile is telling me everything. 48. And what is the successor? Yes, it is 50. Now, let me give you a little tricky number. What would be the predecessor of 1000? 1000. Subtract 1 from this number? Yes. By subtracting 1 from 1000, you get 999. 999 has 3 digits and 1000 had 4 digits. So, see the magic here. By reducing one number from a 4-digit number, we are reaching a 3-digit number. Okay, now let me see who is going to tell me. Is there a natural number that has no predecessor? Yes, half of you must be thinking, Abhi to just now ma'am has asked this question. This is just for the revision sake and just to check how many of you are listening very carefully to this class. So yes, one is that natural number which has no predecessor. Okay, so you think you are very smart. So let me ask you another question. Is there any natural number which has no successor? Thinking? Yes. Remember I just told you there is no number which is the highest or we can say that after this number, no number can exist. Yes. If this is the case, then there is no natural number which has no successor. All natural numbers has a successor. Okay, now all the smarties who are listening to me, answer this. Are all natural numbers also whole numbers? Okay, all those who are saying no, think again. What are natural numbers? Starting from 1 and going till no end. Continued going, counting. And what are whole numbers? Whole numbers start from 0 and again continue like natural numbers. And my question was, are all natural numbers also whole numbers? Yes. Yes, the answer is yes. All natural numbers are whole numbers. Now let us see, are all whole numbers also natural numbers? Why not? Yes, you're right. All whole numbers cannot be natural numbers because we reach the family of whole numbers by adding 0 to the natural number. So 0 is my first whole number. And then I continue counting 1, 2, 3. So all whole numbers are also not natural numbers. Now, can you tell me which is the smallest whole number? Yes, 0. 0 is the smallest whole number. And can you find the largest whole number? Yes, very true. We cannot find the largest whole number. Children, I hope you all are having fun. Today, we have understood what are whole numbers and what are natural numbers. Now let's try becoming familiar with the number line. Are you all ready with your pen, paper, notebook, eraser, pencils? If not, try arranging them as soon as possible. Okay? So now let's have fun with paper, pencil, scale, and an eraser. Okay, and let's try drawing a number line. So open a blank page and write date on the left corner, just like you write in the school, and write topic number line at the center at the top of this page. Okay, now you are ready to draw the number line. Hope you are all with me. I'm not going too fast. Okay, so after writing the date and topic number line, let's leave 5 lines from the top and draw a line horizontally using the scale. Remember, for very small children, we tell them this is a standing line, this is a sleeping line. So a horizontal line is a sleeping line also. Okay, so draw a horizontal line using your scale and be careful, the line should be straight. Okay, fine. Now, the point from where your line is starting, let's draw a small, very small vertical, which may be the size of hyphen or the size of line just above the numbers on your scale. And please be careful, the beginning point of your line should be at the center of this small vertical. Yes, you got it right. Very smart. So now let's write 0 just below this small vertical that you have made at the starting point of your line. By writing 0, we have just labeled this point as 1. Very well done, everyone. So line is drawn horizontally using scale. Now the point from where your line is beginning, just make a small vertical line, just like you write 1. Okay, but you have to be careful that the starting point of your horizontal line should be at the center of this vertical or 1. Okay, and just below this, write 0. By writing 0, we have labeled this point as 1. Okay, now with the help of your scale, mark points on your line. But wait, all the points should have equal distance between them. I am also drawing this side by side. And I am marking points at a distance of 1.5 cm on my number line. You can choose 1 cm, 2 cm or maybe 1.8 cm, whatever you like to mark point on your number line. So I'm giving you some time to mark points on your number line. Okay, here is my scale. I'm marking 0.1. And you know, it's on the right side of the 0. Because on the left side, you don't have the line. Okay. This point I am marking after 1.5 cm, another point, yes. And don't forget to shift your scale. So all done? I am done with marking my points on my number line. And the next step would be, yes, you have to make small vertical line at each point that you have just marked on the line. Exactly the same way that you have done for the starting point of this number line, which we have labeled as 0. So, the next point with a small vertical line after 0, how am I going to label it? Yes, I'm going to write 1 there. So, this point becomes 1. So, now I have labeled 2 points, 0 and 1. So, hope everyone is with me. Now, beneath the first vertical line after 0, I have labeled is at 1. The next point after 1, I'm labeling it as 2. And the next point, yes, we are going to label it as 3. You do it for your own number line and I'm writing this for my own number line. So, I have a 0 on my number line, that I have 1, then I have 2. Now I'm writing 3. I'm writing 4 for next point. Yes, then I'm writing 5 for next point. Then I'm writing 6. And yes, I had written 7 also. Oho. Now there is no space on my number line after writing 7. At this end of my number line, there is little space left between 7 and the end point. So I'm making a small arrowhead on my this end point of my number line. Okay, just after 7. You may go up to 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 15, depending on the size of your number line and the distance that you have chosen to mark points on your number line. Okay, now let me check what is the distance between number 2 and 3 on my number line. And how can I do this? I'm using scale to measure this distance. Yes, it is 1.5 centimeter. And the distance between number 1 and 2? Yes, it is also coming out to be 1.5 centimeter. Children, here I am measuring my own number line. And you have to measure your own number line that you have drawn on the notebook using scale. And you know, children, the distance between two points on a number line is called a unit distance. And all the points on the number line should be at an equal distance, meaning two points on a number line should have same distance as the other two points. And we call this distance a unit distance. Let me check the distance between the labels 3 and 4. It is again 1.5 centimeter. And the distance between 4 and 5? Yes, it is again coming out to be 1.5 centimeter. And yes, the distance between other points on my number line is again coming out to be 1.5 centimeter. So that means I was able to maintain same distance between two points on my number line. And we call this distance as unit distance. And children, don't worry if you don't get it for the first time. You will become better and better at drawing your number lines with practice. So, what we are going to do now is, I will be asking you few questions and you can continue with this practice of drawing number line even after this class. And you can have fun. Use different colors. Use different pencils, use different thickness, and just have fun with your number lines. So, and the questions that I'm going to ask you are very simple, but they are from your exercise chapter 2, exercise 2.1 on page number 31 of your textbook. And you know, the first question is, ready with your pen, paper? Okay. Write the first three natural numbers that comes after 10,999. Very simple. Few of you must be thinking. So write the number, three natural numbers that comes after 10,999. Add 1 to this number and you will reach 11,000. So first number that comes after 10,999 is 11,000. Now I'm adding 1 to 11,000 and I'm getting 11,001. Add 1 to this and you will get 11,002. So you have reached three natural numbers that comes after 10,999. And remember the word next in the question. The word next means you have to find immediate next numbers. That means successors. Okay. Can you tell me three whole numbers that comes just before 10,001? Yes. Some of you might be thinking why zeros come in the numbers. That makes our life difficult. But you know, zero has immense value in numbers. Try making zero your friend and it would be good friend of yours. So how do I find? Now I know I have to find numbers that are occurring just before. So just before means I have to find the predecessor. And how do I find predecessor? By subtracting number 1. So subtract 1 from 10,001 and I get 10,000. 10,000 has how many digits? 5. Okay. Now subtract 1 from 10,000 and you will get 9,999. 9,999 has 4 digits. So subtracting 1 from 5 digit number, we can reach to a 4 digit number. Now it's become very easy. Subtract 1 from 9,999. Yes, and you get 9,998. So now what you can do is write a number or find a number from your surroundings and try finding its predecessor and successor. So after this class, all of you, what you have to do is try drawing your number lines by keeping distance between any two points on your number line same. Second, you have to find numbers from your surroundings, big or small numbers, and try finding the predecessor and successor of these numbers. And to add fun to it, try finding predecessor and successors of alphabets. Have fun, stay safe, stay happy. Thank you.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and produced by Ajit Horo. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.